Hello students, in this video let's continue our chapter pair of linear equations in two variables, algebraic method of solving a pair of linear equations. So second method is elimination method. So in the previous exercise is with the substitution method. So this exercise, next exercise is going to be with the elimination method. So let's see how the method is. In this method, we solve the equations by eliminating any one of the variable. So variable we have to know, so x and y we have. So one variable will be eliminated. By that, we can obtain the value of another one variable. Step 1, multiply both the equations by such a number so that the coefficient of any one variable becomes equal. Okay. So suppose first equation we are having 2x, okay, in another second equation we are having simply x. So what we should do in order to make both the coefficient of x to be equal, so we have to multiply the second equation by 2, okay. So whole equation should be multiplied by 2, so by that we will get 2x in the second equation also. Okay, for that only this first step. Second step, now add or subtract the equations so that the one variable will get eliminated as the coefficients of one variable are same. Okay, if we add or subtract those two equations, like equation 1 and 2, if you are going to add or subtract, depending upon the sign of the coefficient, we have to decide whether to add the equation or subtract the equation. Okay, so by that variable itself will be eliminated. Okay, suppose in the first equation you are having 2x and second equation by multiplying you got 2x. So both are 2x. So how to get eliminated? It has to be subtracted. Okay, so 2x minus 2x. One is in positive, another is in negative, so it will get cancelled. So 2x itself will be cancelled from the equation. Third step, solve the equation in that leftover variable to find its value. So now y alone will be left out, so that value we can find out. Then again substitute the calculated value of variable in the given equations to find the value of the other variable. Okay, so after getting y value, if you substitute it in equation 1 or 2, anything you can substitute, then you can get the value of x also. Okay, so let's see how we are doing in the exercise. Exercise 3.4, first problem, solve the following pair of linear equations by the elimination method and the substitution method. So both method you have to do. So these two are the pair of linear equations. Okay, first we are doing by elimination method. So you have to name it as equation 1 and 2. Okay, then when the equation 1 is multiplied by 2, why we are doing, just now I gave one example, no, same way here you are having 2x, here you are having simply x, so you have to multiply the first equation by 2. Okay, so you can take any variable, x also you can take, y also you can take. Suppose here you are having 3. Okay, the coefficient of y is 3. So here also, in order to bring 3, you can multiply this equation by 3 if you want to eliminate y. Okay, so which variable you want to eliminate, that variable have to have the same coefficient. Okay, so first equation, after multiplying by 2, you will get 2x plus 2y equal to 10. How you got? Here you are having x, no? So when multiplied, it will be 2x. Then 2y. Full equation you have to multiply by 2. Okay, 2y you will get. And here 5 into 2 is 10. Okay, all are having a plus sign. So here also all are in plus sign. No problem. Then after that, subtracting 3 from 2. Now newly obtained equation you have to subtract from second equation. Okay, so like this you have to write. Okay. So this is the easy way to do. If you are going to write like normal subtraction, sometimes you may confuse. So this is easier way to solve. Okay. So place the equation like this. You are going to subtract third equation from second equation. So change the sign of the third equation. Okay, so change the sign. That's why it is subtraction. So hopefully you have to change the sign. So here it is in plus means minus, plus means minus, plus means minus, like that you have to change the sign. Then 2x minus 2x, so it will get cancelled. Okay, plus and minus are there, then it will get cancelled. Here minus 3y, again here also minus 2y. Okay, both are in minus, so put the minus sign and add the coefficient, so you will get minus 5y. Then here plus 4 minus 10, okay, so you will get minus 6. Okay, subtract the number and put the sign of the greater number. Okay, so you will get minus 6. Both the side of the equal to is having minus sign, so it can get cancelled. Then y is equal to 6 by 5. Okay, so here 5 is in multiplication, when it goes to the RHS, it will go in division. So you will get 6 by 5. Okay, then substituting the value of y in equation 1. Now we got the y value, no, that we have to substitute it in equation 1 or 2. Anything you can substitute, you can get the same answer. So x plus 6 by 5 equal to 5. Okay, then take LCM, or you can bring it to the RHS, then do the LCM. Okay, RHS, when you bring 5 minus 6 by 5, then take the LCM, then you will get x is equal to 19 by 5. Okay, so x value is 19 by 5, y value is 6 by 5. This we got by elimination method. So one more we have to do by substitution method. So again do for the same equation only. So substitution method, you would have remembering in the 3.3 exercise what we did. First we have to get x in terms of y. Okay, substitute this in any 5 in equation 2. Okay, this is equation 5. In equation 2, you have to substitute. So you will get 2 into 5 minus y minus 3y equal to 4. So multiply inside and simplify, you will get y is equal to 6 by 5. Then again, substitute in 5. This equation itself you can substitute. Okay, so you will get x is equal to 19 by 5. That's the answer. Then second subdivision. So you have to write the two equations, name it as 1 and 2. Then elimination method means you have to add or subtract these two equations. So how to do? They are not having the same coefficient, so you have to multiply by 2. Okay, so in order to make the y coefficient as 4. Okay, so you will get 4x minus 4y equal to 4. So second equation you are multiplying by 2. Okay, full equation you have to multiply by 2. Then when the equation 1 and 3 are added, why we are adding? Now in the previous problem we subtracted, here we are adding. Why? Because here it is in plus 4y you are having, here you are having minus 4y. Okay, if you add means it will get cancelled, plus and minus will get cancelled. If you subtract means this will turn into plus 4x, then 4y plus 4y you will get, then you can't eliminate. So depending, seeing the sign only, you have to decide whether you have to add or subtract. Okay, so here 1 is in plus and 1 is in minus, so you can add both the equation, you will get like this. So plus and minus will get cancelled like this. So now adding only, no, so add simply. So 4x plus 3x, so it is 7x. Then 4 and 10 is here, so it becomes 14. So x is equal to 14 by 7 equal to 2. Okay, substitute this in equation 2. You will get 2 into 2 minus 2y equal to 2. So after simplifying, you will get y is equal to 1. Okay, so x value is 2 and y value is 1. This is by elimination. Again, by substitution method you have to do. So equation 1, from equation 2 you are changing x is equal to 1 minus y. Okay, that is fifth equation. So substitute this in first equation. So you will get 3 into 1 plus y plus 4y equal to 10. After simplifying, you will get y is equal to 1. Then again substitute in equation number 5. Okay, here it is. Equation number 5 is here. So if you substitute it, 1 plus 1 equal to 2. So again, we are getting the same answer. X is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1. Okay. Then second problem. Form the pair of linear equations in the following problems and find their solution, if they exist, by the elimination method. Okay. So first subdivision is, if we add 1 to numerator and subtract 1 from denominator, a fraction reduces to 1. It becomes half if we only add 1 to the denominator. What is the fraction? So let's take a fraction as x and x by y. Okay. So according to the information. So when you add 1 to the numerator, x plus 1, and subtract 1 from denominator, minus y minus 1, you will get 1 as the result. Okay. Fraction reduces to 1 means it will result in 1. Okay. This is with this we are going to find out the first equation. So you cross multiply. So y minus 1 will go this to the RHS in multiplication. Then you can find out the first equation as x minus y equal to minus 2. This is first equation. Then second information. It becomes half if only add 1 to the denominator. To denominator you have to add 1 means it will give you half. Okay. Only in denominator if you add 1, you will get half. So with this you can find the second equation. So second equation is 2x minus y equal to 1. So by seeing the equation, when equation 1 is subtracted from equation 2, you will get like this. Okay, both are having y, no? So you can simply minus, both are in minus sign. So you have to subtract both the equations. Okay, so you have to change the sign. Subtraction means all signs will be changed. So this plus x will change into minus x. This minus y will change into plus y. This minus 2 will change into plus 2. Okay, so plus and minus will get cancelled. So 2x minus x will be simply x. Okay, so 1 plus 2 will become 3. So x is equal to 3. That's a solution for x. Then substitute 3, x is equal to 3 in equation 1. Any equation 1 or 2, in both you can substitute. So I am doing for first equation, 3 minus y equal to minus 2. So bring 3 to RHS. So minus 2 and minus 3, it will become minus 5. Both RHS and LHS is having a minus sign. So it will be y is equal to 5. Okay, so what's the fraction? Fraction is 3 by 5. Okay, so the numerator is 3 and denominator is 5. This is the solution. So with this, I'll wind up this video and I'll continue the same exercise in my next video. Thank you, children.